Good morning, YouTubers. Another day. We had some rain last night. Nothing crazy, but it seems to be normal here around the ocean. It's still a little bit misty. Behind us, you can see all the colors of the mountains. It's very nice, except all the car bits. I'm ready to make some coffee. Already checked my tires. No surprises here, flat tire. This one is still okay. So we have to replace the tire. This is all my empty bottles I have to take with me. It's all the car bits. Yeah, I have to repack my stuff. But now, as you can see, it's really messy inside. It's always the thing. So, yeah, let's have some breakfast. I still have bread. Some marmalade, have coffee, so breakfast wise is very very good. Machinery wise is very good either. Road wise as well, because the road is very empty. You can see the poles, there's the road, nobody. You can see the mist over the ocean, it's very nice. It's very misty at night, you can't see the stars, nothing. See the birds sleep here. And there were two on the rock here. I hope they mean there's a tunnel over 55 kilometers, not a tunnel of 55 kilometers long. That will be a bit too much, eh? So we make camp again on the beach. There was not much sun today, so it's less warm. It was good for the riding, but it's a bit cold to take a shower now. Just to sit here, I mean, I'm quite warm because I just did cooking and set up my tent. But just when you sit still, it's really quite chilly. I set up my tent. It's there's no really flat places around here, so I put my tent in that way that the lowest point is the back, so I sliding downwards so I can put something behind my feet, and then and that way you can sleep normal. The sunset is right there, so that we move a little bit from the coast. I mean, we didn't move from the coast, but the coast moves, because normally the sunset is in front of us, but you can see it's going around. So the road is all the way there. You can see people already driving, and then it's all the way to the coast. So somewhere there we did camping, on that point, I guess. I don't know how far that is. I'm not sure how far you can look. Make myself some food and some tea. Set up camp where you cannot see the road from here. Maybe if you stand up you can, I'm not sure about that. You see here, there's the road, there's a car driving. We're a little bit lower than the road. So they cannot see my tent, because then there's the road. You can see the signs there if you look very very good. My tent is lower, they cannot see it from the road, but it's a nice place. But yeah, on IJsselmeer they say it's a nice camp spot, but it isn't if you came by tent, as I show you. It's a nice spot, it's not a nice camp spot. If you look like on this side, it's all flat, mostly. But I'm not sure how far the water is coming in, because you can see the shells, so I don't want to go too much in front. And if you look on this side, you can already see my tent. It's going like, it's not straight at all. First I was planning to put it there in the corner. But yeah, and if you walk over there, there's a little bit open spot. That's more nice for camping, but then it's very open from the road as well. First you see there's an empty house. I was looking to camp there, but you can see there's a parking, so there's the road going. So even if you go a little bit further to the water, it's really flat. So yeah, every car shines the lights on you. And although nobody cares really if you do camping on the beach, the thing is you still don't want to have any car lights into my tent, because you try to sleep at night. And yeah, I like it more off the grid. I like it if I don't see the road and the road don't see me. There's a lot of lizards here, small ones. For some reason they're always very close to the water. Yesterday I went back to the water to wash my pots, and then the tide comes in. I reckon now it's already high tide. But yesterday there were so many crabs, that's unbelievable. I'm not sure there's many today as well. I'm not sure how they do fishing, because they're always sitting on the rocks and then the water they splash over them. But I always there's one. I always think they were eating fish, but I guess not. There's another. And it's incredible, because yesterday there were quite big waves and they smash over the crabs and they just keep sitting there. See the bird there, another bird there. See the big crabs there. Not sure how they do the fishing or what they're eating. Maybe they eat the shells. It's crazy, eh? This one is not scared. Another big one there. How can they hold to these rocks? It's amazing. So we're all packed, ready to go. It's 9:30. There's no sun yet, so it's not too warm. We have to do about 2 kilometers or so. There's supposed to be a shop, I hope so, because now I have about 2.5 liters of water, so there's not so much. If there's no shop, the next shop is where the hotel is as well. That's 60 kilometers. It should be possible. That's not the big issue, but it will be nice to buy some new water. Because this water is already, this is the fourth day, I think. Tonight, yeah, this is already the fourth day of this water, so the water getting really old. But yeah, there's no choice in it, it's better than nothing. It still tastes normal, smells normal, whatever, but yeah, all day in the sun with this heat, it can be really good. So yeah, without further ado, let's go to the shop and then let's find the hotel. It's always something when you kind of run out of water. You have to find the shops. You go to a shop, shop is closed, and you're a bit worried about the water. And next to you there's the biggest ocean you can imagine. It's all full of water. But yeah, you're so close to it yet so far away because you cannot drink it. And yeah, funny part about the ocean is it's salt water, but It isn't really. I was reading this article about it, and a guy did research on the ocean water, and he claims only 10% of the ocean water is salt water, and 90% is fresh water. But you have to find a way how to separate it, and he actually did. When he take water from the ocean, he add a chemical to it. Then the salt water combined with the chemical. When you remove the chemical, you lose 10% of the liquid, but you are left with 90% fresh water. So this method, now they come to do research on it, or they can use it for drinking water or whatever. But yeah, it's quite interesting if that works out. The whole problem with water around the world is fixed with a simple chemical. So that will be great. Imagine when you're just cycling here, you need water, you take a cup, go to the ocean, add something, and you have fresh water. It's perfect, right? You already can buy the taps to put in dirty water, and they clean it. So imagine you have these pills just for to make from salt water fresh water. That will be great. You can see up front, there's the tunnel. It's 1 kilometer long. So if I drive 50 kilometers an hour, that's 4 minutes in the dark. It's quite small. The road is quite small as well. I'm not too happy about it, but it's the only road. Luckily, there's not too many tunnels in this country. But so we made it out of the tunnel alive. What I did is put my phone here with a torch. There's a flashing light here. Flashing right here. This one is burning and reflecting, and this one is burning as well, but yeah, that shines nothing, but it lights up a little bit. This is quite scary, tunnels like this, because they're very small. This tunnel actually had a small sidewalk, but the problem with the sidewalk is it was less than a meter, and because it's very dark, you cannot see the sidewalls, and the sidewalls are not not flat, but there are all rocks in different formations, so it's very hard. An option is walking, but when you walk next to your bike, you're actually wider. So I try to ride as fast as possible through it, but a few minutes feels like hours. There was only one car coming in my direction and a few cars going in the other direction. When a car passes you, because the tunnel is so small and the sound keeps reflecting to the walls and the roof, when a pickup truck crosses you, it sounds like a train is crossing you. It's absolute. It's, I don't know. It's incredible how the sound gets stronger when you're in the tunnel. So normally I think you can go over this top, but this is not possible for us. I'm not sure they are still building it. Once it was a road, or I'm not sure what they're doing, but they're constructing on it. But yeah, it's not connected to this road either right now. It looks a very small tunnel. Now from this side you cannot see it, because it's dark. Because the tunnel goes like this. But when we enter, you already can see the end of the tunnel. So you see where you're going to, but yeah, very scary, but we made it, most important thing.
We made it to the hotel. 2 days of camping and 1 day of hotel before. And now we are here. And it's another 3 or 4 days riding to Antofagasta. I wanted to stay in a different hotel, but it was fully booked. The downside is if you don't make a reservation, these hotels can be full. It only happened twice before, but yeah, today this happened. Now we stay here, but this is almost twice the price. Instead of 15, this is 25. It's quite nice because we have a fridge. It's already cold. The fan was already running when I walked in. The room looked quite nice as well. Even the toilet is very nice. And kind of clean. I mean, that's how far as it goes. We have a table to sit, another desk. So that's great. So tomorrow we can make some video. Here it says Monday to Saturday the breakfast from 7 to 9:30, and on Sunday and the festival that is 8 to 10. So there's breakfast. There's also Wi-Fi, but I have to ask what the code is. I didn't ask that, of course. I forget it. And they don't put that on the sign. I always hate when they don't do that, because then you have to walk downstairs. And sometimes they give you the paper, this is good. If you don't give the paper, it's a problem, because they put it in your phone. But maybe here's a different network than downstairs. Then I want my laptop. I have to go down again, search for these people, because they're not at the desk. And just put it on the in the room. Anybody is in the room who wants Wi-Fi, right? But, yeah, anyway, that's the next thing. First, I'm gonna take a shower. Then I kind of look for some food, because I'm quite starving. Because I showed you last morning, I had these crackers I buy. They're actually quite good, but I have nothing on top of it. So I eat like 60 or 65% of the packets already, but I'm still starving. And I eat about 2 muesli bars or so. But it doesn't work out. Supposedly there's a nice Peruvian restaurant around the corner. I already saw it as well, and the people write about it is nice. I saw they have a menu for 3,000, so that's about 350 or 4 euros or so. Yeah, we'll check that out. I don't know what to expect, because the food in Peru wasn't that great, but why not? It's around the corner and we can check it out. So we didn't go to the Peruvian place, we just crossed the road. But it is, looks very good actually. There's mayonnaise, tomato, cheese, ham, chicken, salad, fresh bread, even the bread is warm. It's quite big, if you see my hand. If you like this video, put the thumbs up, leave a comment down below. Don't forget to subscribe, share with all your friends, family and anybody you know. And I see you in the next video.